hand of God. Now, Genesis chapter 2, 22 tells us, and the rib which the Lord God had taken from the man, he made, fashioned, formed into a woman. And he brought her, the woman, and presented her, the woman, to the man. Genesis 2, 22. The Lord assigned Adam the task of naming the creatures of the animal kingdom, the then animal kingdom. And as he did for Noah, when he brought the animals to the ark, the Lord miraculously brought the animals to Adam. And as they passed before Adam in this first animal parade, Adam granted a name to each creature. What a collaboration between Adam's spirit and God's. The word of God says that God wanted to see what Adam would call each creature. God had already assigned names for the creatures, and Adam tapped into the spirit of God for those names. Genesis 2:20 tells us, and Adam gave names to all cattle, to the fowl of the air, and to every beast of the field. But for Adam, there was not found a helpmeet for him. So after this exercise, no suitable life partner was found for Adam. Obviously, the Lord knew Adam's life partner would not have been among the animal kingdom. But I believe he was ensuring that Adam would see the vast difference between all the animals that he had to name and the woman he would eventually be blessed with. Fortunately for you men today, you do not have to go through the exercise of naming all the animals to see if there is a suitable life partner for you. You looked out among the sea of humanity and you located that one individual that you wanted to spend the rest of your life with. That one individual that you wanted to be the mother of your children. However, it was not an automatic selection. There was still something that had to be done. You had to ask for permission in most cases. Permission from the love of your life, if she would marry you, number one, as well as in some cases, permission of your spouse's parents or guardians or significant others to receive their blessing on your union. And, you know, I'm hoping that you can, you know, put your mind back to those many, many years ago for some of us, and you would have asked for your spouse's hand in marriage. Now, to take someone's hand in marriage is to ask for permission to marry the individual. And you, the male, in some cases the female, you would have sought your spouse's hand in marriage. Let's look at how this depiction was done by a father for his son. We're going to see this video very shortly.
Sir, I'm a bit nervous about being here today. Still not real sure what I'm going to say. So bear with me please if I take up too much of your time. You see in this box is a ring for your oldest. She's my everything, and all that I know is it would be such a relief if I knew that we were on the same side. Cause very soon I'm hoping that I can marry your daughter and make her my wife. I want her to be the only girl that I love for the rest of my life, and give her the best of me till the day that I die. Yeah, I'm gonna marry a princess and make her my queen. She'll be the most beautiful bride seen. I can't wait to smile when she walks down the aisle on the arm of her father, on the day that I marry your daughter. She's been here every step since the day that we met.
I'm scared to death
treating her bad. I've got most of the best done so far.
So bring on the better ones.
Until death do us part, there's no doubt in my mind. It's time, I'm ready to start. I swear to you with all of my heart, I'm gonna marry your daughter and make her my wife. I want her to be the only girl that I love for the rest of my life. And give her the best of me till the day that I die, yeah. I'm gonna marry your princess and make her my queen. She'll be the most beautiful bride that I've ever seen. I can't wait to smile when she walks down the aisle on the arm of her father. On the day that I marry your daughter, the first time I saw her, I swear I knew that I'd say I do. I'm gonna marry your daughter and make her my wife. I want her to be the only girl that I love for the rest of my life. And give her the best of me till the day that I die. I'm gonna marry a princess and make her my queen. She'll be the most beautiful bride that I've ever seen. I can't wait to smile as she walks down the aisle on the arm of her father. On the day that I marry a daughter.
Amen, amen, amen. But I'm not sure how many of you had such an extensive marriage proposal, but I hope that you would have remembered that day when your spouse popped that question, will you marry me? And, you know, remember that special moment. You know, sometimes you don't go back down memory lane, but remember that time when you asked. You know, it might have been a surprise. It might have been planned. You might have been aware. But, you know, these are things that we need to recall and recall those times. I remember that evening when my husband asked me to marry him very, very clearly. He was clear about coming to fulfill God's call on his life. So I knew that my answer to him was not just about marrying him and becoming his wife, but also about sharing his vision and helping him to fulfill his purpose and going with him wherever that was. Very recently, the Lord highlighted the fact that all that we need to do, everything that we need to do and accomplish is in our hands. Yes, it's in our hands. It is written in our hands. I still didn't grasp what he was saying. And so he explained. He said, why is it that when persons who want to know your future, they ask to see the palm of your hand? Why is it that they want to look into your hand? Because it is written there. Remember, we are made in the image and likeness of God. And so our names are engraved in the palm of his hand. And since we are made in the image, which is a character of God, and the likeness, which is a functionality of God, there are things that are engraved. And so remember, when it comes to business deals, remember that a handshake was considered binding. Business deals were built around the concept of a handshake. The handshake says that I bring what is in my hand to partner with what is in your hand. Even personally, we need to be mindful of those with whom we shake hands. You must listen to the Spirit of God. In Galatians 2, verses 1 to 10, Paul pointed out to the Galatian believers that his message of salvation, God's grace, without following the law, had been formally approved by the other apostles. Paul met with the other apostles in Jerusalem, and the three most influential leaders, James, Peter, Cephas, and John, saw the grace given to Paul by God to carry out his ministry, Galatians 1:15. In other words, they agreed with Paul's testimony that Christ had been revealed to him and had called him as an apostle. So those three gave to Paul and Barnabas, his partner in ministry, their seal of approval. And what was that? It was called the right hand of fellowship. We might assume that this is a kind of official handshake, but what the right hand of fellowship represents in the New Testament is acceptance and inclusion. So I invite you to fellowship with me, and I bring to this relationship all that is in my hand. So when we ask for someone's hand in marriage, we are actually saying, I want to spend the rest of my life being a part of what is in your hand and allowing you to be a part of what is in my hand. That's pretty powerful. I think if we understood that, we would be more careful about, we need to let our children know that we need to ensure that we are careful about who we partner ourselves with. We need to know what is their vision, what's their purpose, what are they about? When the Bible talks about the two of you shall become one flesh, it begins with the unifying of purpose and destinies as laid out in your hands. So the Lord made a presentation of Eve to Adam. He brought her to Adam. Can you sense, the Lord's, readiness to just show Adam what he had prepared? You've seen all these animals, you've named all these animals, but look what I have created for you. I can't say how the presentation was done, but it was a formal presentation with God, in essence, performing the first wedding. God was the first father giver. Someone coined the word her, H-E-R, as his eternal rib. I thought I was so cute. So the Lord instituted the bonds of the marriage covenant, which is actually called the covenant of God in Proverbs 2:17, indicating that God is the author of the sacred institution. And this is the marriage model and was instituted by God. You remember Adam actually said to God, the woman that you gave me, that's the model. It was a woman presented to Adam. Proverbs says, wisdom will save you from the immoral woman, from the seductive words of the promiscuous woman. 17 says, she has abandoned her husband and ignores the covenant she made before God. So it's a covenant. It's a covenant. In What a God, the Anatomy of the Almighty, from pages 1 to 5, you will see an account of what the hand of God reflects. And we see that the hand of God reflects his power to save. The hand of God reflects his power to save. A number of other things, but we look at the saving power of the hand of God. Jeremiah 32:17 says, ah, Lord God, nothing, absolutely nothing is too difficult for you. The Lord who created the heavens and the earth, the Lord who saved the Israelites from a pursuing army, the Lord who instituted marriage and brought you together, he has the capacity to save your marriage, to restore, to repair. There are some situations in your marriage that you have deemed impossible to repair, impossible to heal. By you, yes. But with God, nothing, absolutely nothing is impossible. He can repair what is broken. He can heal what is hurting. He can make the impossible happen. However, you have to bring it to him. Bring before him what is broken. Bring before him what is hurting. Bring before him what you think is beyond repair. The word of God says that a bruised reed he will not break, and a smoking flax he will not quench. He will not brush aside the bruised and the hurt. He will not. Sometimes we can be insensitive to those who are the hurts of those around us, but God will not brush you aside. He will not disregard the small and insignificant, but he will steadily and firmly set things right. He won't get weary, and he will not quit. He will not be stopped until he has finished his work to set things right on the earth. Isaiah 42, verse 3. God, who is the master designer of this institution called marriage, he will not quit. He will not quit. He is not going to quit. So please don't give up on God, because he will not give up on you. Don't give up on him. The marriage, it may seem impossible, it may seem hopeless, it may seem something that you can't attend to, which is true, you can't, but give it to God. He is here. God has assured us that this is the season in which he is going to restore and sweeten marriages. Won't you give him the opportunity to do that for yours? He can save your marriage, and he can also save your soul if you will let him. His pierced hands represent his deepest expression of love for you. He is ready and waiting as you, but he needs you to acknowledge your need of him and the forgiveness of your sins. If you are here and you're ready to accept the Lord as your Savior today, you have never accepted him as Lord and Savior of your life. If you're willing to have the Lord take the reins of your life, if you're ready on this, the first day of the year 2022, to have the Lord take the steering wheel of your life, you just need to accept what the Spirit of the Lord is saying to you even now, because the Spirit of the Lord, he convicts the heart. You need to believe him by faith and confess with your mouth by repeating this prayer after me. So if you're willing to accept the Lord as Savior tonight, we're going to do it right now. Just repeat this prayer after me. Lord, I acknowledge that I have sinned and done wrong in your sight. I acknowledge that my sins have separated me from you. I believe that because of your love for me, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to this earth to die for my sins. I hear and now confess with my mouth all my sins and ask for your forgiveness of my sins. I surrender my heart, the throne of my life, to you, Lord. Thank you for the cross of Calvary. Apply the blood of Jesus on my heart and life. I accept that by faith I am saved. By faith I am now your child. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I love you. Please give me a love for your word and a love for prayer. In Jesus' name I have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. If you said this prayer in faith, believing that Christ has saved your soul today, send me a private message that you have accepted the Lord as Savior of your life. As we continue to look at our hands, there are some hands that need to be cleansed tonight. If you want to ascend to the hill of the Lord in 2022, we need to have clean hands. We need to have clean hands. And so I want to ask you to repeat after me. Lord, I open my hands in your presence and I lift them up to you for your inspection. I confess, Father, that I have used my hands to hurt, to abuse, to commit sexual sins, or to dabble in strange fires and altars. I repent today, Father, for allowing my hands to be compromised, for allowing my hands to be instruments of unrighteousness. Please, Father, wash my hands with your precious blood and apply your blood in my life, so that I will have the power to live above sin and anything that displeases you. Father, anoint my hands, consecrate my hands for your highest purposes. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Creator of heaven and earth, master designer of marriage, This is your assignment, your design, your strategy for the season. And so you have already provided the grace needed for the restoration, the healing, the renewal, refreshing, and the sweetening of every marriage represented here. Father, I ask today that you stretch your hand out towards all those in need of your presence today. There is no situation that is beyond your ability to restore. No situation before you that is beneath your availability to restore. Father, every marriage represented on this altar tonight, I present to you and I place them in your pierced hands in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. The hand of God has the power, has the ability to save, and it reflects his power to create and sustain, not just to save, but to create and sustain. The Lord who brought into being has the capacity to keep it from falling. I am sure that he is able to guard what I have entrusted to him until the day of his return. 2 Timothy 1 verse 12. God is the author and the finisher. He is the Alpha and the Omega. He is the beginning and the end. He is at the same time author and finisher, at the same time Alpha and Omega. He has the capacity to keep what has been entrusted to him. So God, the hand of God, has the power to save. It has the power to create and sustain. It has the power to heal. God's hand has the power to heal and restore from sexual misconduct or from barrenness. From barrenness, God can heal. The hand of God will oppose the enemies of marriage, sexual sins, materialism, distractions, barrenness, lack of intimacy. And so I want you, as we stand on the word of God today, and as we believe what God is going to do, I want you to open your mics, and we're going to declare from Exodus chapter 15 what God is able to do for our marriages. So go ahead and open your mics, and we're going to make this declaration together concerning our marriages. Are you ready? Hallelujah. Let me hear you say amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So you want to, I want you to say this with an attitude. I want you to declare over your marriages the power and the might and the strength of God, the excellency of his power to work in your marriage. So read after me from Exodus 15. Lord. You are my strength and my defense.
You are my strength and my defense.
The Lord is my warrior.
The Lord is my warrior.
Your right hand, O Lord, is majestic in power. Your right hand, O Lord, will shatter every enemy.
Your right hand, Lord,
that is opposing my marriage now in Jesus' name.
That is opposing my marriage now in Jesus' name.
Throw down now all those who oppose my marriage. Cattle. Brimstone on their habitation. Creator of heaven and earth.
Creator of heaven and earth.
Stretch out your right hand.
Stretch out your right hand.
And let the earth swallow every plan.
Every altar, every covenant
that has been sent or set up against my marriage.
That has been sent or set up against my marriage.
Hallelujah. Now I want you to stretch up your hand to his. Stretch up your hand as far as you can, as if you're reaching up to hold on to his hand. So stretch out your hand as far as you can, as high as you can. Hallelujah. And I want you to say after me, God, you are the one who designed and instituted marriage.
You are the one who designed and instituted marriage.
I ask you now to take my hand. And receive everything that is in my hand, including my marriage. Hallelujah. Heal every broken area. Fill any gap that I have given the enemy access to. I release every impossible situation into your capable hand. Please uphold my marriage. With your righteous right hand. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Father, we thank you, Lord, that you have heard these prayers today on this altar, your altar. Father, visit every home. Hallelujah. 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 Visit every marriage represented on this altar today. And Father, do a perfect work. Father, you're here to restore. You're here to heal. You're here to repair. Father, even if there are no issues, Lord, you're here to sweeten. So, Father, every marriage represented on this altar, including mine, God, we ask that you will touch tonight in the name of Jesus. God, we commit on this first day of the year, every marriage represented on this altar to you. God, we thank you, Lord, for your presence. We thank you, Lord, for your glorious right hand. We thank you, Lord, for your righteous right hand. And God, we pray in the name of Jesus that you will act on behalf of all the marriages here today. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen and amen.
Amen.
For every aspect of the anatomy of God that we look at in What a God, there's a personal application. And so for the hand of God, you are engraved in the palm of God's hand. And so your marriages are under God's personal care. Hallelujah. And so tonight, before I give you the assignment, I'm going to encourage you to stay to the end, because even the song that we play at the end of the program is a song that the Lord gave to us, because he wants you to be assured of his love for you. And so before I give you the assignment, we are going to have a time of intercession for your marriages. This has been, and this is the backbone of this ministry, intercession and prayer. And so we need our facilitators to come to our aid tonight. And so as we prepare our hearts for prayer, we are going to have a song at this time. And I want you to prepare your hearts. Prepare your hearts for prayer. Prepare, just wait before the Lord as we listen to this song and receive our prayer today as we intercede on behalf of your marriage today. God bless you richly. Hallelujah.
Your word that you've been waiting for all night.
You are true and faithful to your words and your promises. We magnify who you are, O God. There is no searching out of your understanding. Ancient of days, we bow in your divine presence. We worship you, O God, that thou and your entourage chose to grace us on this day. You showed by your very presence, Abba, that marriages are dear to your heart. We thank you for your visitation on this very first day of this year. this year 2020 that is represented by open hand. Ah, Father, we worship you, O God. There is none like you. We thank you for instituting marriages. We thank you for gathering marriages with your hand, your right hand of power and your right hand of righteousness, for gathering the different marriages that you have desired and chosen to gather on this day on your altar. Ancient of Days, we thank you. We know that you are a God of purpose. And by bringing the different marriages here, oh God, it is because of your purpose that you have for them, to bring each marriage to your expected end. Father, we give you thanks. We thank you, oh God. Marriages that have given up, marriages that are hemorrhaging, marriages that are infected, marriages that are affected, marriages that are barren, marriages that are bitter, marriages that are sour, marriages that are full of shame, marriages that are filled with tears, marriages only ye asata ya masungiri basota riba sata ya masukari abasete, marriages that are shameful. Ah, Maria basundiri basika, marriages that are being tolerated rather than enjoyed. Zundiria sateye musundari basiki, marriages that are cauldrons, O God, of hate. Kande yi sata yi masundari basiki, yet, Ancient of Days, you have gathered. Our Father and our God, you gathered from the east, you gathered from the north, you gather from the west, you gather from the south. With your hand, your right hand of power, to showcase to the extent that men will know that you are who you say you are. Yahweh, we say thank you. We thank you for the gathering of these ones. We thank you that you are the pillar and the center of each one of them. We thank you. Not only are you the pillar and the center of each union, you are the maker of each couple. We give you praise, O God. We give you praise, O God, because your ways are not our ways. We thank you for your gathering today of these various marriages. We hallowed your name because you are the restorer. You are the true and the faithful one. What you cannot fix, what you cannot impart, what you cannot change, what you cannot do, Ancient of Days, does not exist. We know for a fact that all power, power to change, power to restore, power to refresh, power to renew, rests in your hand. All power belongs to you. And that is the confidence that we have, that your same hand have gathered all these marriages to the ends that the enemies of marriage, Zundari Satayama Sundari Basoto, will feel the impact of the might and the power of your hand. Father, we thank you. There is no power that is greater than your power. There is no power that can resist or contend with you. We thank you for who you are. We parade before you, Ancient of Days, the mighty man of battle that you are, Jehovah Sabaoth. Zaria sundiriba shika tarama sundiribusika. We tremble as we stand in awe of you, Yahweh. We parade them before you, Ancient of Days, whatever they are called, addiction, witchcraft, infidelity, bitterness, and the list goes on, unforgiveness, and the list interference. Father, the list goes on, and so we parade them before you, the one who is the beginning and the end, by whom all things were created, known and unknown, seen and unseen. Father, we parade them before you. We stack them up against the might of your power, and they weigh nothing. So we ask that thou, O God, arise and let the enemies of your first institution be shattered. Zuria masanda yisa turiba sundaria sata. We declare on this day that enough is enough. Enough is enough. We are so thankful that you chose this day as we possess the gates of 2022, as we possess the gates of January, which stands for opening of the gate. Father, we are thankful that you took your rightful place within the domain of your institution. We are grateful and we are thankful that every enemy that will come through the gates will meet with you and the power of your might. We say thank you. We say thank you. We say thank you. We say thank you for that which you will do, for the shame that you will bring upon every enemy of this first institution of yours. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Father, we thank you for your hand that will oppose every enemy of marriage, that will expose every enemy of marriage, that will bring illumination to bear for those who are deceived by the enemies of marriage. For the enlightenment of the eyes of understanding that you will do, for the transformation that you will do, for the wholesome work that you will do in and amongst the couples represented here this morning. Father, we thank you. We thank you because you are able and you are faithful, faithful to deliver, faithful to finish that which you have started, faithful to restore that which is committed into your hand, faithful to underguard. We thank you for the hope that is being infused in the hearts of couples. We thank you for that which you have started by your Spirit. Spirit of the living God, we welcome you. We acknowledge you publicly. It is not by might, it is not by power. Might has failed, power is useless. That is why we come. That is why we come. That is why we come. And that is why we're enlisting your help. Spirit of the living God, we ask for the miraculous that you alone can bring to bear. Miracles to start within the hearts, within the emotions, within the soulish realm of couples represented here. Ah, Ancient of Days, that you illuminate the various candles that are upturned before you on this altar. The candles that the lights have gone off, the candles that the wick is smoky, the candles that the lights are flickering, the candles that are bent out of shape, zondari sateye sondeye makuya basata. We touch your grace as concerning strength. Strength, O God, to upright every bent candle in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. A fresh touch, Ancient of Days. A fresh breath, Ancient of Days. Hope that can only come from you and your presence. We worship you, God, for that which you will do. The miraculous, O God, and the testimonies that will come. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Father, we bring every attendee before you, O God, that they will in truth and in spirit take refuge in you and in your word, forgetting those things that are behind, placing their hands, like the presenter has said, and their marriages in your hand and leaving it there. Allowing you to undergird, allowing you by your mighty hand to undergird and hold, even as they journey through these 21 days. Father, that they will take refuge. They will take refuge. They will take refuge in you and in your word. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, no matter the boisterousness of the storm, even after tonight, that their eyes will be fixed upon you. Spirit of the living God, I'm asking for special undergirding for this cohort, this very first cohort of 2022. Yahweh, we dedicate them unto you because you are the God that loves first as a first fruit. And so I'm asking for a special undergirding, zonde yasataya sataya sataya. Sataya, no matter the boisterousness of the wind or the storm after tonight, the grace to stay, Yahweh, under God, as you alone can by your spirit. We send your word into homes. Zunta sata lima sunda riba shia sata raba seke diribu shinda riya sata. Light has come. Light has come. Every home represented on this platform. Light has come. We command exit of darkness. We push back the forces of darkness. It doesn't matter what you're called. We know that at the mention of the name of Jesus, you have no choice but to retreat. And so we command a backing up and a dissipation, even as the light of Yahweh has come by virtue of their presence upon this altar. 44 are here. Open door, open door. We open the door to the King of Glory. We open the door to the light of the Ancient of Days. We open the doors of the hearts of the couples that are here to the illumination and revelation that comes from the word and the presence of Almighty God. We open the door to encounters even in sleep. Ancient of Days, we bless your name. We bless your name. We thank you because every junior and the people united in marriage, they are clay before you, O God. And thou who art the potter, we commit every clay into your hand, asking the ones that are marred, O God, that you do that which needs to be done. The one that needs firing, O God, that you refire afresh. The ones that need blessing, O God, that you cover with your grace and your mercy. To the ends that thy name alone will be glorified. And victory and restoration will be our portion. This we ask in no other name but the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, we give you thanks. We give you thanks for that which you will do. We thank you for the various gates that are open. We bless you, O God, for the retreating of the agents of darkness. We thank you for testimonies that will come. We magnify you for the undergirding. Yes, undergirding. In spite of the billowing and boisterousness of the storms, we thank you, Holy Spirit, for brooding. And we thank you, Yahweh, for this confidence that we know that you are able. Not only are you able, you are faithful. And as Jehovah Sabaoth, we never lost the battle yet. So we thank you. We applaud you, the man of war that you are. We thank you for restoration, for recouping, refreshing these ones that you have chosen for the very first episode of this year. We thank you for your hand. We thank you for your hand. We thank you for the confirmation of that which you will do. Your hand have gathered. This is the year represented by hand. We receive all that you're pouring out in this season over the institution of marriage. And we thank you. We bless the marriages that are here for the privilege and blessing that will be theirs for being the very first for this year. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for the privilege.
Amen, amen, and amen.